Hello friends, how are you all? So today I'm going to take you to the resort city of Germany. It is near to our home actually. It comes under the Aachen district. It is called Monschau. It is a resort city of Eifel region. Actually it is within the national park. It is a very very beautiful city. Come with me and have a look.
Monschau is in the Eifel region of Aachen, and Eifel is very very touristic place. I have already made a separate vlog of Eifel, other type of areas also, like Ruhrberg. I already made a vlog on that lake, that is also comes in the Eifel region, and Monschau is another part of that region. It is very very touristic place. It is very rich also in every sense, in tradition, in culture, and also in terms of wealth. People are really wealthy. So if a expensive car comes on the roads of Aachen, we immediately say, okay, this must be from Monschau. The city which I am going through is called Rutgen, and it is also a very famous city to live also. People here are also very wealthy, and for tourism also this city is very famous. It is actually spa city of Aachen. There are so many thermal baths here, and water is very rich in minerals. So if the person is suffering from any skin diseases or neurological diseases, they come here to take a bath, and it really helps in the healing, in depression, anxiety. It's true that its water has very healing power. So if the city is very famous, and houses are also here actually not very expensive, so people also tend to live here if they are looking for cheap accommodation. It's not so cheap also, but still in Aachen city it is totally uncontrollable. Prices are too high, but in these areas prices are still manageable. As you can see, it is a basically a little bit hilly area, and houses are less, and it's not so heavily populated, but people have very good standard of living. They have basically farmhouses or holiday homes. That is how they earn money. And this is the city of Monschau, where I wanted to bring you here. And these all cars, you can see, they are actually the tourist cars who have parked car here. And this was the center of the city where all the people have come, and we could not find a proper parking place here, and it was actually too much crowded. So we thought of going to a different entrance. That was one of the entrance to the city, but because so many people were there, so we thought that maybe there is a isolated area where we can go and enter the city a little bit less people there. But we got disappointed, and I will tell you how. But in a sense, it was good because we saw a different route to the city entrance, and normally we'd never take this route, but this time we took this route to enter the city from the another end, and it was beautiful. Actually, this was a disappointment. Look, you can see again that so many cars are again here, and these cars are parked. There are also tourists, and so there was crowd from this side of the entrance also, and it was a huge disappointment because of the corona. I didn't want to go to such crowded places. We were avoiding it because not many people wear the mask, but anyhow we took the risk, and we thought that okay, we will do our best to avoid the crowd and just take some pictures and then go back, because my husband really likes this area. It is more like our Himachal Pradesh of India, That is the only hilly area I have seen in my life, Himachal Pradesh. And I love that place. And Monschau is a little bit like that. Means hilly areas, villages, houses. And I also saw a school here on the hills. Actually, this city is more famous for the textile industry. Fire. And this is the city center. This means, you know, city center starts here. This is a church here. And you can see there are people. Yeah, they are maintaining social distancing, but still there are, you know, too many people. Not everyone was not wearing mask. Some people who are in on risk group, you know, like old people, they were wearing mask. The church which you saw was built in 1810. So, and these red houses, they are very, very famous, and they are still, you know, preserved like that. Nothing has changed. I mean, they have not renovated as such. You can see the structure. The architecture is still so old, and that is how they have preserved their heritage. It is at the 517 meter height, this city. Means it is pretty high. Not so high also, but still pretty high. And you can see the church made in 1810. You can reach the city by bus or by car. There are enough, actually, parking spaces enough. And there are so many biking trails here. Look, you can see it is so much, it is such a beloved city that people have come here in so much, you know, crowd. And for the last 300 years, nothing has changed much in the city. You can see the houses are still like 300 years old houses are these houses. Houses have slate roof, and their population is also only around 11,726. But most of the people are only tourists. They are preserved buildings, and it is a very good sight. So some of the photos, because we keep on actually coming here, it is our actually go-to place. So some of the photos are also from my previous trips. I just added on just to show you that how it looks like. That this is actually the winter look, how the city looks in the winter. In winter, you can see the city. This is a castle here. Actually, here French also have their own, you know, colony. Like French also have ruled this area. So, you can, the architecture is also has influence of the French. So the languages is also English, Dutch, and French. They have used how they have explained it. All the information. This is the industries which they used to be here, textile industries. You can see so old houses. If you go to France, then also the architecture is just like that. I have been to France also. In France, old cities, architecture is just like that. That is how the houses are. So you can see, where the France ruled, the architecture was like the France. There is always a canal in such cities, and you can see this is the winter look of the city. And people love it. Whenever we have guests from other countries, we bring them here, and they all love the city. Because every country has its own architecture, own beauty. So when people from other countries visit some other country, right, you will always be fascinated, no matter from where you are. This is German tradition. When it is Halloween or it is Christmas, they always decorate their window shop windows like this, according to the festival, and looks very beautiful.
Friends, I hope you liked today's travel vlog, and if you did, please hit the like button, share it with your family and friends, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do it, and I will see you in my next video. Till then, take very good care of yourself, stay healthy, stay happy, and stay blessed. Bye-bye.